A Kantian to the Critique of Political Economy by Karl Marx. Audiobook 5x17. The state gained considerably upon the score of taxes, as well as the creditors upon their capitals and interest, and the nation, which was the principal loser, was pleased, because their standard, the standard of their own value, was not debased. 50 Stoyart thought that the nation would prove more alert with the further development of commerce. He was mistaken. About 120 years later, the same quid pro quo was repeated. It was just in the order of things that Bishop Berkeley, the representative of a mystical idealism in English philosophy, should have given a theoretical turn to the doctrine of the ideal unit of measure of money, something which the practical Secretary to the Treasury had failed to do. He asks whether the terms crown, lever, pound sterling, etc., are not to be considered as exponents or denominations of such proportion, namely proportions of abstract value as such, and whether gold, silver, and paper are not tickets or counters for reckoning, recording and transferring thereof, of the proportion of value, whether power to command the industry of others be not real wealth, and whether money be not in truth tickets or tokens for conveying and recording such power, and whether it be of great consequence what materials the tickets are made of. 51 Here we find a confusion, first of the measure of value and the standard of price, and secondly of gold and silver as measures on the one hand and mediums of circulation on the other. Because precious metals can be replaced by tokens in the process of circulation, Berkeley comes to the conclusion that these tokens represent nothing, i.e., only the abstract idea of value. Sir James Stoyart had so fully developed the theory of the ideal unit of measure of money, that his successors, unconscious successors since they do not know him, have added to it neither a new version nor even a new example. Money, which I call of account, is no more than an arbitrary scale of equal parts, invented for measuring the respective value of things vendable. Money of account, therefore, is quite a different thing from money coin, which is price 52 and might exist, although there was no such thing in the world as any substance which could become an adequate and proportional equivalent, for every commodity. Money of account performs the same office with regard to the value of things, that degrees, minutes, seconds, etc., do with regard to angles, or as scales do to geographical